QoS, what it is and how to measure it. Put very simply, quality of service, or QoS, is a set of policies to give certain data traffic in a network priority over other traffic. Why is this important? Well, not all traffic in an IP network is equal. It doesn't matter if some data traffic is slow as long as it gets to where it's going in the end. But then, there is data traffic for connections known as real-time services, where problems are immediately noticeable. Specifically, think of voice over IP, where you notice if there are problems with the underlying traffic flow. But what exactly is QoS? And can you monitor it? Let's start with what it is. Let's suppose you want to take a bus to the train station where you'll continue your journey by train. So you get on a bus headed for the station. After a short time, the bus hits a traffic jam that was caused by an accident. Uh-oh, you're gonna miss your train. If only you had a separate lane on the road that only the bus could use. Well, in many modern cities, this is a reality. Buses have their own lane and they can keep their timetable regardless of the traffic on the roads. Buses are prioritized over other road users. QoS works in exactly this way. The road corresponds to the bandwidth of your data connection and the bus corresponds to a prioritized data packet, such as is used for a voice or video connection. QoS is like giving these data packets their own bus lane to guarantee the quality of the service even during peak traffic periods. Quality of service technologies are designed to make IP networks real-time capable and ensure that important applications function smoothly. There are essentially two ways to apply QoS principles, either through integrated services or INTSERV, where you give certain data traffic a priority, or through differentiated services called DIFSERV, where you mark specific data packets as having a high priority. So how do we ensure QoS? We've established that QoS is indispensable for real-time applications like voice over IP, but it can also play an important role in other applications like enterprise resource planning systems. Many companies often have branch offices outside large cities that are not always connected to the head office by a fast internet connection. The data must be sent and received through this connection. It is therefore practical to prioritize the data traffic of the ERP system over other traffic such as HTTP in order to prevent interruptions in the connection. So QoS is clearly vital. And while setting your QoS policies is one part of the puzzle, another very important part of it is monitoring it. Because it's only through monitoring your network that you can know what QoS policies and protocols to implement. Your approach to monitoring should be twofold. Firstly, monitor your network before implementing QoS. This will give you an idea of where potential bottlenecks or issues can occur, and you can plan necessary upgrades. The data will also inform what QoS policies you need to implement. Secondly, you should monitor your network after implementing QoS. This will ensure that your policies are working and that you don't miss problems that might arise. So what exactly do you need to monitor QoS? Well, you can't monitor QoS directly, but here are four network metrics that should inform your QoS decisions. Delay or latency. This is the length of time it takes for a packet to get from sender to the receiver. Long-time delays in the delivery of voice over IP data means poor audio and video quality. Plus, delays in discussions make it difficult to communicate remotely. Jitter. Jitter measures the variation of delay. That is, how consistent is the delay? Do all packets have a similar delay or low jitter? Or are some packets fast and others slow? High jitter. If there is high jitter, voice and video streaming will be very choppy. Packet loss. Packets can get lost, arrive as duplicates, or arrive in the wrong order. This could happen in cases of network overloads, poorly performing devices, or hardware and software errors. Packet loss can directly impact the quality of a service. The mean opinion score, or MOS. This is an important measure of how users perceive the quality of the network, and it's often used as the single overall benchmark of quality for a voice over IP call. MOS is calculated using a combination of the number of lost packets, the average delay, the average jitter, and an R value that expresses the subjective quality of the connection. So how do you monitor these metrics? Sometimes manufacturers provide ways to measure QoS natively on their devices, like many Cisco devices let you monitor QoS metrics. But what you generally need is a network monitoring software that has the capability of monitoring all the metrics I've mentioned. An example is the network monitoring solution that we develop, PRTG Network Monitor, which has sensors like the QoS roundtrip sensor, ping jitter sensor, mean opinion score sensor, and native sensors for monitoring Cisco devices. If you like this video, consider subscribing and give us a like. If you have feedback, write a comment, or you can tell us what topics you'd like to see us cover. You have so many options. Know what else offers you options? PRDG Network Monitor. You can learn and understand all about your device data through comprehensive dashboards and reliable alerts and notifications. PRDG is your solution to monitor everything. Why not check out our free trial? Link is in the notes below.